Hi, it's Liz. Oh my god, guess what? One day until surgery. God, I'm so stoked. I'm starting to get a little bit nervous now. Just like, because I was studying to be a nurse, I have seen operations right in front of me. I've been in the operating room. I've seen the procedures done, that sort of stuff. It's creeping me out that I know, like, what happens. Like, I'm thinking too much about it. I'm thinking about, like, oh, the surgeon, like, cutting my skin and stuff. Oh, no. Like, that's freaking me out a little. And, you know, just, like, the whole setting of, like, the theatre is, it's, like, so cold and clinical, and, like, I know there's gonna be people, like, running around everywhere, and I'm just a little freaked out, that's all. It'll be fine. I got my hair cut yesterday. I don't know if you can see, but it's got red foils in it. Oop, other way. It's going to take a while to progress to the colour I want. It's the colour I want on my regrowth, but it's still really dark at the ends. It's a lot shorter. They cut off quite a lot of length, so I'm a bit sad about that. It was really long before, and now it's kind of just long-ish. And I got my nails done. I don't know if you can... Oh, I hate this webcam. Oh, they're sparkly. Yeah, I had my call from the admissions nurse this afternoon, and she did say that I can, because she said no nail polish, but then she said, oh, but acrylic's okay, as long as the nail polish isn't dark, and I do have acrylic. So I was like, oh, thank God. And because I have the clear, you can see my nail underneath. She just said because of the sat monitor and stuff, you know, it has to be able to pick up the amount of blood in your fingertips, and I don't know what nail polish has to do with that. I don't know. I knew that they do use your nails to check capillary refill. If it takes more than a second or something like that, it's, you know, you've got poor circulation in your hands or your feet. I've decided to keep my toenails clear. I'm just going to do a clear coat on them. Just in case. I'm going to be getting my TED stockings. I'm excited about that. TED stockings are basically a standard for everyone in Australia who has to stay in bed for like more than a day or something like that. When my boyfriend went in for a day surgery, he was in overnight. But he was able to get up and move around like immediately afterwards. He didn't have to have them, but I think anyone who is going to be laying in bed for extended periods of time needs to have them. They prevent blood clots, deep vein thrombosis, that sort of stuff. They're just like really tight stockings, and they help the blood move up the leg back to the circulatory system. I will also be getting, what does she call them? They're the ones that inflate. I can't remember what they're called, because I've never worked with them before. So I will be getting them, and I get to keep them both, which is kind of cool. What else did she say? I've got a 6:30 a.m. admission. I'm fasting from midnight. I'm not even allowed water after midnight tonight. I presume they're going to set up my IV fluids as soon as I get there, because they don't want me to be dehydrated, seeing as I can't have water. I will have to have a barium swallow. I think we say, in Australia we say barium, but everyone else says barium. So I think it's called a gastrographin swallow test. And the pre-admission nurse said that we go over the road and do the swallow test. If everything's good with that, then we get to go on to clear fluids. It's just like water and tea and stuff like that. And if all is good, I will be discharged midday on Saturday, this Saturday. So hopefully I will be discharged. at midday. Sorry, I'm a little bit. My head has just been like crazy today. I've just been running around getting stuff done. I spent 5 hours getting this hair done yesterday, 2 hours getting these nails done. It's ridiculous. And then I made a chicken soup this morning. It's just carrot, potato, leek, onion, and chicken with like a little bit of butter. And it also has thyme in it, and salt and pepper, that sort of shit. And I've blended that up and put it into my little 1 cup containers and put them in the freezer. And probably one of those will last me one day, seeing as I'm only going to be having 50 mils of liquid at any given time. And I'm supposed to be having 6 small meals a day of 50 mils and constant sipping of water throughout the day. I'm going to chuck in some photos at the end of this to show you guys the supplies that I got for my clear liquids, which is only going to be one day. So basically from midday when I get discharged from hospital and until the next day. On the next day I get to go on to thickened fluids, so they don't have to be clear. So I bought a whole stack of stuff for that. What else do I have to say? This will probably be my last video before I go to hospital. I might be able to post in hospital, but I don't know. We'll see how it goes. What else do I need to say? Shit. The post-op, no, pre-op diet. See, my head is like just not screwed on today. The pre-op diet is going well. I haven't really lost any more since the first week. It seems that I've lost 10 pounds in the first week and the second week has just been nothing, which is fine, whatever. I don't mind as long as I get my friggin' Lapband. I've been like perfect the whole time. I have not gone off the recommended diet the whole time. I've been really, really super strict with myself. But the last couple of, it's been like 2 days, we did the shopping for post-op and we got some refried beans and I opened them up and I wanted to try them because I've never had refried beans before. And I've had maybe like a tablespoon of refried beans yesterday and today, and I feel a little bit guilty about it, but at the same time, there's hardly any fat or calories in it and it's like, protein's good and it's filling and, you know, I haven't gone overboard. You know, at least I'm not eating chocolate or like friggin' McDonald's or something. But yeah, so I'll have a weigh-in tomorrow. I'll record that on my blog just so I have a point that I can make reference to. That's about it. Alright, so I'll see you guys after I have my band. Oh, I'm so excited. So nervous, so excited. I don't know which one's more. Nervous, excited. Oh. Anyway, it's going to turn out great. I know it. It's going to be awesome. All right, bye, guys.